Monster House is hitting the road. First stop, Vegas.
This week, Monster House tries to make its mark in a town well known for its monsters.
It's Mardi Gras House.
She's a mean one.
There's a 300-pound bald man in my garage sewing.
Oh, my God.
Our house was plain and simple. It was safe and normal. It was nice and sweet. But we all agreed we could use a change. And then something happened that was very strange. Cause a van showed up, all our stuff went flying. And my mom was crying till the job was done. Now it's a monster house. It's a monster house. It's a monster house. And we all just love it. It's a monster house.
Meet the Waldens, a Las Vegas family with a longing for Louisiana's Cajun culture.
Mardi Gras, part of Louisiana, which is a really mixed culture, lots of fun, wild people.
I'm a musician, and I love the whole jazz scene down there. I think that's one of the best things about it, and the food and the music is awesome.
We love Las Vegas.
Oh, yeah.
We love Las Vegas.
That's great. But are they ready for Monster House?
You don't think I'm ready to be on Monster House?
She's not running around the house like she normally does.
Yeah, she runs around this little media niche screaming her head off.
I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready.
Okay, but how do they feel about being holed up in an RV for a week while Steve gets to do everything his way? To bring Mardi Gras to Vegas, Steve summons monster designer Todd Erlinson.
Todd, we're hitting the road. We're going to Vegas.
We found ourselves a house. It's a Las Vegas tract home. The family's really cool. They're open to anything. They want a Mardi Gras thing. I think we should focus on the bottom level right here and zoom that in.
All right, so you're right in the front door. That's where you got this long room when you first come
right
in.
When I'm thinking Mardi Gras, I mean, I'm seeing Bourbon Street. If we could do the street down the middle of the living room, I think that's definitely the way to go with that.
This whole space, you got this long space, so that could work for a street, but then you got to get the building, you're kind of trying to get the buildings inside the house.
And then we can do the bottoms of the balconies all the way down the street to give it the feel like you're walking down Bourbon Street. Let's take a look and see what that would look like with all the stuff we just talked about with the balconies and
the red brick floor. Okay, so
I like the breakfast area in the back.
Right.
You know, it's still practical, the red brick flooring. These lampposts are awesome. And with the confetti, that's just going to create the party. You know, that's your party atmosphere. The shutters on the inside, that looks like the outside of a building right there. That's perfect. That's exactly what I'm talking about. All right, well, that's Bourbon Street.
What's that room back there?
Right now, it's a living room. That could be our blues club. This pony wall could disappear, and that could be the outside of the blues club. You know, something real rustic.
Something like this, I guess.
So there's your blues club right there.
Great.
That's sweet.
The problem with losing this pony wall is that now we have no place to put this iguana.
This is an iguana.
It's an iguana.
Okay.
If we're gonna have a blues bar, we need to have a bar, first of all. That'll be a good place to put the aquarium that the lizard's in right now inside the bar. Yeah, let's see what that would look like. That's exactly what I'm talking about right there. That's perfect. That's it. Now we got a home for the lizard.
So what are you missing? You took away their entertainment center, right? So you gotta get that back in the picture.
Make this huge entertainment center that is our Mardi Gras mask.
Behind the mask.
Lots of colors, you know, like the court gestures hat. So you kind of have an idea what I'm talking about there?
I do.
And that's our monster.
It's Fat Monday, and our Creole King of Construction, Steve Watson, comes marching in with this week's crew. Lon Simons, Master Carpenter. John Morgan, Construction Supervisor. Tom Cat Lay, Finish Carpenter and Sculptor. Sean Pritchett, Paint and Drywall Man. Al Lyman, Welder. Can these local legends pull off a month's worth of work in just 5 days? If they do, they'll each get a tool package from Makita, Aesop, and Stanley worth over 4,000 doubloons.
Oh, God, I see Steve coming.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Are you getting excited now?
That's me on and cracking.
All right, guys, come on.
Oh, there he is.
There we go.
Dude, that is so cool.
All right, I need to take those keys, and we're going to get to work.
All right. All right.
Look at that RV!
Finally, guys.
Okie dokie. Go! I got the big bed!
All right. We're building Bourbon Street right here. Street lamps, sidewalk, a brick street. And this is a blues club right here. And this other area is just the facade of another street front. Maybe the bottom parts of some balconies, you know? It's got to look like you're in Bourbon Street. That's the French Quarter. So we will head in here. Whoa. That's their new entertainment center. Whoa. But this thing's gonna come up, you know, it's gonna be real decorative, have, you know, pieces going everywhere. We're gonna build a bar. It's gonna be also be the terrarium. You see that? So it'll be the bar. They'll separate the kitchen from the living room, give them a place to live. So that's basically what we're doing there. What you guys have is this as a reminder that time is ticking. 4 days, 15 hours, and some change. Well, let's do this thing.
The lumber arrives, and homeowner Chris is already starting to panic.
Lizard.
Before the demo can begin, they need to relocate the reptile.
You're gonna chill. You're gonna chill out. Chill out.
Oh, there goes the mouth.
Carry the cage over sooner than later.
Crikey!
Slow down, hold on.
She's a main one. Let's get this thing over there.
The team treats Vincent the iguana to a vacation in the neighbor's garage. Then it's time to get down and dirty.
Monday, we've had a really good start today. We've got all the demo done, all the carpets out. Tomcat's our artist, and so he's kind of taking the responsibility of working on our biggest project, which is the big Mardi Gras mask entertainment center. It's gonna be Tomcat and Lon working on that. Lon's our finish guy. The other guys are framing this wall out that's gonna be the housing for the entertainment center and also the facade for our blues club. So far, this Monday's been great.
The entertainment center will hold a high-definition TV on one side and a karaoke machine on the other. To make these accessible from both rooms, they will be built on a prefab motorized turntable. But it will be up to the team to figure out how to make the Mardi Gras mask doors.
Let's figure this out so that we know exactly what we're gonna do.
So I can give you this look, this heart-shaped face on the doors. And then as far as three-dimensionalizing that, we might have to just come up with some foams.
Lon suggests using the old Monster House standby, foam.
I can have the foam, I can have it sprayed. If you want to go with a rough frame and then do the chicken wire and the lath, I can have it sprayed on Wednesday and hard cut it on Thursday, which is gonna be
real tight.
But sculptor Tomcat prefers to use a material he's more familiar with.
It's a product called Structolite. It's a sort of a lightweight plaster that's also heat resistant.
What about the foam versus that plaster stuff?
There is no versus. We're doing the plaster
for
stuff.
For sure.
Yes.
I'll
make that call and you can blame it on me.
Plaster it is.
On Bourbon Street, John oversees the framing of the Blues Club's facade.
Hold it right there. Level.
Top boy.
All the way to the top plate.
Fire in the hole.
Knock it over that way. Set.
Top. Very top. That's good.
It's called organized confusion.
Out back, Al makes wrought iron trim for Bourbon Street.
This is the main wrought iron span that's gonna go down the side of that Bourbon Street. Pretty heavy, so
It's gonna take some monster big screws to hold up.
He's welding forged scrolls to a half-inch steel bar.
Shit, that's good right there.
Al has been throwing sparks in Vegas for 12 years.
Vegas is mostly about the strip for the tourists, but there's a lot more to it when you get out here and get away from it. There's lots of stuff to do outdoors and just hanging out at the lake and riding, stuff like that. The reason I wanted to get on the show is, like, I watch it all the time. It looks like fun, you know, get on, make an ass out of myself. Can I say that?
Next door, Steve is sealing up a nosy neighbor's window.
Our producers caught the neighbors here peeking in the windows from the bedroom here after we specifically said no peeking because it's such a close neighborhood and all the houses are so close together. We caught them peeking, so now we're just gonna tape up the window so they can't see out. They might get a little upset about it, but, you know, you gotta follow the rules.
But this doesn't stop homeowner Natasha from searching for clues in the dumpster. Steve decides to give her some privacy.
Anytime we have nosy homeowners, we have to deal with them accordingly.
Can hold me.
Wow.
I am Natasha Dini.
That's a shame.
I've escaped better dumpsters than this.
That's a shame.
Inside, Lon and Tomcat are making curved doors for the entertainment center.
They will just make some radius ribs to match the radius of this circle, of this turntable. We took one rib. I designed one rib by matching the radius, copied it onto a piece of ply, cut it out, sanded it just the way I liked it. Once I got it to where I wanted, we overcut some other ribs that will screw this template to those ribs, router it out, and every one of the ribs will be identical.
For a guy used to building casinos, this monster challenge seems easy.
Said, I'm pretty much used to doing this kind of thing with the company that I work with now. We do very high-end work. We don't take any shortcuts. Jeez, I don't think I have enough fingers and toes to count how many casinos we've worked on. Mandalay Bay, Aladdin, Venetian. If I learn something new every day, my day's not wasted.
This has been a great Monday. Great first day.
The Blues Club has a facade. Bourbon Street has wrought iron trim. And ribs have been cut for the Mardi Gras mask doors. So our confident Cajuns decide to call it quits early.
All right, man, be good. Good work today.
All right.
But Monster Monday is just getting started out in the Coachman.
Our neighbors are coming over because every Monday night, even before we got on the show, we would get together and watch Monster House. So we're having an ice cream social with our neighbors.
What's going on, guys? How you doing? Well, I decided to stop by and watch the show with you guys tonight. Just, you know, but if you don't like it, I don't want to hear about it until I'm gone. You guys can talk about it after I'm finished.
I didn't think it was possible for you to turn any more red.
Wow.
And we all just love it. It's a monster house.
It's 6:30 in the morning on a Tuesday. We're trying to scope out the house, but we can't really see anything.
Now that I think about it, it's like, what have we gotten ourselves into?
It's day two, and our team is already smelling victory.
Getting ready to maybe think about wrapping this puppy up.
Today's first challenge is to build balconies to line Bourbon Street.
What I think the look we're catching is a different building here, a different building here, and a different building here. Like you're walking down Bourbon Street.
You know, these can be balconies from two different buildings, but they should be the same size. Otherwise, it's gonna look retarded.
Why don't we just build a soffit over the top of this?
Give some room.
Cool, cool. That's what we'll do.
To create the illusion of balconies, John suggests putting up soffits, which will later be trimmed with wrought iron.
Coming through, and I think we're gonna pull this off ahead of time.
In the Blues Club, Tomcat and Lon glue together the ribs they cut out yesterday to make a frame for the radius doors. Then they skin the outside of the frame with Luon plywood. But is this dynamic duo showing signs of friction?
Tomcat's the artist. He had the vision, but Lon has kind of taken charge of that whole process.
Oh, no. Chop them all at once?
All right. So far, Tomcat's just kind of sitting back and just watching. He's just going to let him do it. We'll see how long that lasts.
Do me a favor, just to make sure. Check these diagonals, just to make sure. Because if not, you know, I'd rather be safe than sorry.
It's not going to matter. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I'm cutting a big fat thing out this way and a big fat thing out that way. It's getting a little frustrating, but we'll get over it. It doesn't have to be this complicated. It could go faster.
Out back, welder Al has come up with a clever way to make a replacement banister.
We're gonna start replacing this rail. Luckily, we saved the old one for a template, make it a little easier.
Alan's pretty much the metal guy. He's your basic beer drinking welder, good old boy out back. The guy's doing some brilliant things. Instead of throwing out the banister yesterday, like I think some of the guys wanted to do to kind of shock the homeowner, he kept it as a template, and he's basically copying that for his new banister he's building for the staircase. And that's smart.
Hey.
But what would Mardi Gras be without monster decorator Jerry Schwartz?
We got a nice clean slate here.
What's up, Jerry?
Hey.
How you doing, girl?
Good, how are you?
Fine, welcome
to Vegas. The color scheme in here is gonna have to just match just like a classic blues club.
Are we putting any lighting in here?
We're gonna put some lighting in here. I'd like to talk to you about lighting and see what you can find that would just fit that theme.
Okay. I think I can kind of add some spice and jazz things up and make it really festive and bright and cozy and kind of sexy in here.
That's exactly
That's
what I'm looking
for.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, here it is, day two. The crew is having their little lunch, doing their thing.
Back to work. I am so sorry. I'm sick of you guys just slacking. If I don't see you back in the house, working on my house, you guys are gonna be not in a good stand. What, you don't take me seriously? You don't think you need to get back in the house? Are you sure? Oh. Get to work!
Well, that was fun.
They brush off the silly string and get back to work. Sean finishes the soffit balconies while John hangs plantation shutters.
There you go. Good job.
We got some to do.
In the blues club, Tomcat test fits the curved doors, and Lon starts grooving on the lizard bar.
Don't yell at me, I got feelings.
I'm not yelling.
So why is Steve looking so sour?
We still don't have a mask, and I've been begging and pleading with these guys to give me at least a template of what the mask is gonna look like. And they have yet to do that.
But Tomcat is still thinking big easy.
This thing's in the bag. Oh yeah. My face ain't here, but it's in the bag. I'm pretty confident.
Just after sundown, the banister heads for the party.
That's awesome.
Looks what, pretty
oh,
good.
Oh, seeing it in here, it's so much different than seeing it out there. That's great.
Done!
Steve treats the team to a little payback.
And we all remember the attack of silly string from our wacky homeowner, Natasha. The one thing they said that is their pride and joy they don't want touched is their bed. They have this great bed upstairs. Well, it looks awful lot like this. So whip this thing up, which is identical to their headboard upstairs. Like what we're gonna do is have Big Boy here go out there with a sawzall and they're just gonna somehow see that he's cutting up their headboard.
That's our bed! What the? That's our bed! You're not supposed to touch the bed!
Hey, what's going on? That's our bed!
Whoa! Hey!
Oh my God!
Are you serious?
That's our bed! Oh.
What?
You weren't supposed to touch the bed!
I didn't know. Nobody told me.
I'm telling you now.
I just needed the short piece of steel to finish.
That piece of steel my ass, Big Boy. No. You know what? Put it back together. I'm glad you guys think this is funny. My husband had that bed custom made for me. I'm not happy.
Hey, Natasha.
Nice, Steve. Hey, good night, Steve.
Come here. Thank you for the silly string. This was a prank. This is not your bed. Yeah. We made this to look just like your bed.
Yes! Oh, that's awesome.
right, good day's work.
With the fun over, the team calls it another early night.
See you tomorrow.
Morning, it's day three, and it's time to bring the monster out on this house.
Tomcat shows up with a truckload of bendaboard, which he wants to use for skinning out the circular entertainment center.
I'm just cleaning out my garage. It's actually doing me a favor, getting it off of the way. Got a better use for it now.
Oh!
Yeah.
Good morning.
Get back in that trailer. Close that door.
You got it backwards. I yell at you. You don't yell at me.
Why don't you wait till I put some makeup on or something before you put that camera up my nose?
And what do you use that for?
Well, your walls are all out.
Wow. We're constructing?
The homeowner doesn't know this, but the walls are really out of plumb. Everything's all crooked, and this is going to straighten them out.
You may even want to get a list going.
They start day three with a punch list.
We get a list, they're going to hold us to it. Do a punch list.
Well, from what I understand, that's what it's all about, right?
Okay, let's do it.
Break!
Tomcat is finishing off the top and bottom of the entertainment center. Sean has jumped on the drywall, and Lonnie is working on the snake cage.
Right off the bat, John and Al hit a road bump on the lizard bar.
Well, originally they were gonna put the lizard in here and make them slide out on some glides, but that thing's so heavy that we think it might just tip the whole unit over.
What happened to it?
Well, put wheels on it. That way there's no chance of it falling anywhere. It slides in and it slides up.
That sounds just wonderful to me.
So now we're talking cutting this, pulling all the cripples out, and building a rolling cart.
Aquariums that sit on here, we're gonna put some casters underneath it. When they get here, they'll just be able to pull them out of the back. Clean his cage up, whatnot.
With the new plan in place, Lon starts on the siding.
The wood that I'm gonna finish this in is a siding called T111. On the horizontal, we're using this. That's what the plan kind of looked like, and it's the easiest way to do it, rather than have to actually make the siding or buy the siding and nail it on individually. This will give you the same look.
Tomcat skins the circular top and bottom sections of the entertainment center with bendaboard.
This is actually MDF. It's a very dense cardboard, if you will, but it's still wood. And it's with all these grooves in it, why it allows you to bend it. All I'm gonna do is laminate a couple of layers together. Once the glue's dried, it'll retain that shape, and it'll be really hard to bend it any other way. We'll hang our doors, cut our doors, start tossing some mud.
He gets started turning the doors into a face.
There's looking at you.
Nice. It's like monster LASIK eye surgery or something.
The design also calls for a three-pronged jester's hat to be made out of fabric.
This man right here is offered to sew.
You want me to do what?
You're gonna be our seamstress.
I'm a little nervous about the sewing thing. I think I'm gonna give my mom a call to see if she can help me out. We're gonna basically build some tubes.
You're gonna make tubes out of the fabric. You put right sides together and sew them down.
I'll ask her a question.
Steve wants to talk to you for a minute, Mom.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah?
I was just, I'm sitting here with Sean, and, he's a big guy. And I was just wondering, what was your grocery bill whenever he was growing up?
Drink was all about the same size. He's running about $800 a month.
Well, good for you. As far as this was concerned, you did a good job. But thanks for the sewing lessons, because we're going to need him to sit down at the sewing machine. And he's basically our monster seamstress this week, so I appreciate it.
Night falls, and the joint is jumping. Lon impersonates an iguana to test out the terrarium cart. At just after 5, Tomcat is finally ready to start sculpting the mask. He attaches metal mesh in the shape of a bird's beak.
Now I'm starting to mix up. The cool guy struck the light. I'm getting it ready to apply it to my mask. It's just like spreading icing on a cake. We'll put a first layer on there, let it fill up all those little holes.
How long does it need to cure?
12 hours, maybe less.
Yeah, how long you guys plan on working tonight?
8 or 9. Does that sound good?
You want us to work till midnight?
Tonight?
Yeah.
You guys do whatever you feel like you need to do. That's how I feel about that.
And
and I ask Lon how long they plan on working tonight, and they're gonna leave around 8 or 9 o'clock, so it's gonna be about a 13-hour day for these guys. That's just not a good way to get this challenge done. There are only 2 days left, so if they wanna leave at 8 or 9, it's completely up to them, but doesn't help their chances of getting this build finished.
All right, let's call it night.
See you tomorrow, man.
It's day 15. We're still here.
It's been well over 12 hours, but Tomcat's Structolite is still soggy.
Should have had heat on it last night, huh?
But with less than 40 hours left, he's running out of dry time. So he decides to lay on the finish coat over the still wet base.
We're definitely going to have some dry time involved here, but it'll be down to the wire on the dry time.
The rest of the team is down on Bourbon Street. Sean sprays on a texture coat to give the walls an exterior look. Then they bring in Al's wrought iron trim. At 11 o'clock, Tomcat comes to the realization that his mask will never be dry in time.
Drying very, very slowly. Too slow for my patience.
We gotta get this mud to set up quicker. So we're gonna set up a couple more heaters, get some more heat going in here, and hopefully we can get the stuff to set up a little quicker than it is. It's just taking too long. We don't have the time to wait for it to dry. 150,000 BTU air blower. Blows hot air.
They got about a day and a half for this, for the mud to dry that's on the mask. Now, right now, they've come up with an idea to put some heat on it, and they brought in this torpedo heater, which is probably going to bring the heat up in the house to close to 100 degrees. That's their idea. They're married to that right now, so I'll just sit around and see what happens. But me personally, I think it's a bad idea.
Not happy about that.
With only 33 hours left, Mardi Gras has come to a crashing halt.
This is too much of a pressurized project for this particular material. Today, I think I've learned that if you don't have that much time to work with this material, don't.
Kind of made me want to go get a beer.
This structure should have been addressed a lot earlier in this week, and so now the guys are up against the wall.
Steve grabs the rudder and makes a sharp left turn.
Spray this. This whole idea is not working out. We're gonna have to go with foam. We don't have time to try to wait to mold the, all this other stuff to make the three dimensions. We're gonna just mold this mesh, get it ready for spraying, and it'll be your day. That's the only thing we can do to make sure that we get this deadline.
But shifting to foam this late in the game is a huge risk.
I'm not even sure it's gonna happen, even with the sprayed foam. I don't know that they're gonna be able to do it. We'll see.
Sean and Tomcat start redoing the botched nose job.
Doing okay. Now we're gonna put some lathing on here and get ready for the spray foam guy.
When the nose fell off today, that kind of freaked me out. So what we decided to do is go ahead and go with some sprayed hard-coated foam. It's either do that or these guys have no chance of making it anyway.
Then there's that jester's hat that still needs to be sewn.
Hey, Tomcat, I'm going to the material store, man.
Okay. See when you get back.
Sean heads for his first ever visit to a fabric store. When who does he run into but designer Jerry?
What are you doing here?
Well, I was coming to get fabric, but
that's what I'm doing. You couldn't wait for me?
Jerry and her giant head inside to shop for fabric.
I'm feeling like a designer. Jerry.
So do you need these for the bottom part at all?
One for the side, one piece, that and that. Give me three. Please.
There you go.
Please.
I thought that's what you were gonna say.
Manners? She's teaching me manners? I thought we were just shopping.
In and out, so I don't really know.
Yeah.
But,
it's going good.
He's so cute. He's working his booty off.
Back at the house, John works on the Blues Club wall.
Putting up shiplap. Shiplapping the wall.
Another wall will be covered with corrugated tin. Out in the garage, Jerry gives Sean a quick sewing lesson.
Do you know how to sew?
A little bit. My mom taught me a little bit long time
ago. Are you like 10?
Probably more like 8.
Okay. Do you know what this is?
Nope.
Okay. We're off to a good start. This is called a bobbin.
Okay.
Pop it in the machine.
All right.
And thread the machine.
Okay.
It'll stop when it's ready to be done. Get your needle up and thread it through that itty bitty hole. So there's a little practice pad right here.
Okay.
That you can take and go in here. You're gonna let your pressure foot down, if I knew how to do it.
Is this one?
Yes, it is, see? Mm. Your mama taught you well.
Yeah.
Go into the fabric, and hopefully we'll be able to sew. Okay, so as you see, the machine is sewing. All right,
Here we go. Good luck. Thank you.
The foam for the mask doesn't arrive until 8 o'clock. A temporary spray booth is put up, and the foam starts flying.
Everything is just coming to a bottleneck, and right now, there's a bunch of foam being sprayed on it.
I knew from the beginning, dude, I'm all, that's going to be the whole thing, dude.
This is great.
But the foam still needs to be carved and sanded, which means a long night for Tomcat. Out in the coachman, daughter Barbie wonders what's going on in her garage.
There's a 300-pound bald man in my garage sewing. I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous. He looks like he's never sewed in his life, and it's a tiny little piece of, like, red curtain. It's crazy.
Incredibly, 3 hours later, our stout seamstress has pulled a hat out of his hat.
So, no kidding.
Yeah. I'm doing the stuff and I'm pulling.
Look at those stitches.
Nice. You're the monster seamstress of the week.
Crash course and he pulled it out like that.
Yeah, this is great.
Looks awesome.
So what do you guys want to do now?
Well, you guys want to call it a day?
Dude, I hate to tell you.
It's on me.
Oh, this whole week's on you now.
You have no fear. I'm going to be here all night, guys.
Good.
The reason I'm putting the lines on there so I can get everything kind of get a better view of what I'm doing. I don't want to cut too much off and have to repair too much. Kind of like Close Encounters of the Third Kind. And this is my pile of mashed potatoes.
Avion, call my agent.
It's Friday, ladies and gentlemen, and we're going to, as they say, kick this pig.
Day 5 finds a tuckered tomcat still at the Mardi Gras.
Worked till about 3 o'clock this morning, and I found a pile of wood to nap out on.
But a mask has emerged, and it's ready for the team's verdict.
I'm impressed.
I think Tomcat's outdone himself. It's quite incredible.
That's gonna be the highlight of the project.
Friday, day 5. We got 14 hours and 30 minutes left, and things are looking really good. Finally, things are coming together.
We got all the wood up on the walls. We got the tin treatment that's gonna go up in just a little bit. This mask finally has come together and looks great. Now it's just coming down to getting this hard coated, get it painted, and all the fabric. Put the turntable in.
They also need to make doors for the Bourbon Street side of the entertainment center and trim the balconies with wrought iron. And what would Mardi Gras be without a confetti blower?
So here we go. That's awesome.
Al welds wrought iron for the balconies.
Let's get a go around our little balconies there to make it look like they got a little railing on there.
I gotta find a place to hide this confetti blower. So I've decided to put a planter box in the little cafe, and then I'm gonna sheet it.
That's right.
Hi.
What's up?
Are you ready to sell
today? What you got for us?
I got some Mardi Gras beads. I got some wire cages that I'm gonna hang from
those
Bourbon
Street.
Those
are cool, Street. I like those.
Do you like these?
Cool.
And I'm gonna get some ferns for down Bourbon Street.
Yeah, these are sweet.
So?
This is kind of like the color scheme I would like on the mask.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Something along those lines.
Yeah.
I haven't found the green yet, but I kind of, I found some burgundy pants.
Right, okay.
So I have a lot of masks, and I have some fancier masks upstairs that I have not pulled out and showed anybody yet.
Right.
So I've got some fun stuff going on.
We're taking these doors off to do further work on them, smooth them out before the hard coat.
That's beautiful, man. These things are lightweight. Now we're gonna take our prepared foam, and we need to fill in the little voids. We're gonna use 5-minute hot mud. We are under the gun on getting it hard coated. We have about an hour before they show up. But what we have to be careful is we put this stuff on too heavy and it won't dry.
Al makes bases to hold some Bourbon Street lamps, bolting them to the floor using a ramset.
This is gonna be the stand for the columns. Go up under the iron. That's beefy, dude.
Yeah, that's not going anywhere.
Hell no.
That's not going anywhere.
That's beefy.
That sounds like you're firing off a cannon or something. So how you guys doing? How you feeling?
Good, man.
Feeling pretty good.
Real good.
A lot of work still to be done?
Nah.
So how do you guys feel about this midnight deadline tonight?
We'll be done by 7. This thing's over.
All right, it's never happened, but I'll say one thing. If you guys are done by 7, I would be willing to up the stakes a little bit.
And
if you're done by 7 o'clock, I'll have a limo out front by 7:30, and we'll be at the close by 8.
Sounds like a date.
All right. Let's do it.
With the deadline now 5 hours closer, Al and John hurry to get the tin wall up.
I got you.
The foam boys arrive to hard coat Tomcat's mask. The team seems to be a sure bet to win Steve's 7 o'clock challenge when suddenly they get stuck in some 5-minute mud.
Well, basically, there's moisture getting sucked up with the hard coat's been sprayed on right now, and it's sucking the moisture out of the mud, the 5-minute mud they put on. But it's cold out, and it's a little moist out, so the 5-minute mud still has moisture, now it's making it bubble up like this. And basically, it looks horrible. And it's not their fault. It's just, the mud was a bad idea, basically, and that's presenting a huge problem.
Try your sander on it.
Oh, while it's tacky?
That way we can go back over it.
I guess just come out here right now and try to sand it down. We have to come out and sand it down and see if that'll work. Maybe that'll fix the problem. If not, they're screwed.
It's a do or die situation, so I'm gonna try to take off as much of this wet mud as I can. Already, yeah. It just took that one little pass. But anyway, I'll use the damn pants. Knife. You done with them doors?
Yeah, I'm trying to help.
Dude, man, I'm in a hurry.
I love you, man.
I love you too, bro.
They take turns sanding off the wet mud. Then try another stab at hard coating.
This mask looks great.
I love this, man. This is excellent. I should have thought about this in the beginning. I should have just took everybody's advice. This is so excellent.
That looks incredible.
The mask crisis has left them with only 1 hour to meet Steve's new deadline. But they're still cocky.
Maybe we better have a big man making some clean clothes real quick.
So we'll do.
Well, we got the entertainment center. We've got this window. And I believe that's it.
No, real fabric.
Well, the fabric.
45 minutes, guys.
Chill down those beers. Putting up sheet rock, buttered up, boo-doo-doo, bag of nails.
All right, guys, we got about a half hour.
Yeah, exactly.
They rushed to hang the jester hat.
So let's see.
That's one more thing down right there. 17 minutes to go.
Al has made a curtain stand to go between the TV and karaoke machine. With just 10 minutes left, the team tests out the turntable.
180, come on.
It's hitting.
The curtain stand is an inch too tall.
Well, yeah, she's binding up a fuss.
The team scrambles to chop it down to size, but now the plasma cutter won't work.
Power's on.
Nothing. I need a compressor hose in the back. Compressor turn on? Nothing.
Go! Got it close.
I need a hood, dude. This...
Okay.
Yeah. Right there, dude. Right behind you, Sean.
Here, let me grab do it. Let me do it.
Come on, dude. Shades, you're just gonna blow holes in the man.
Give it to him, bud. He's got it.
Done. It's hot. Minute 22.
52 seconds, guys.
40 seconds.
40 seconds.
Test
it up, see what it looks like. And is it going to clear?
That's the other stop.
Yeah. Guys, that thing is done. Yeah. 15 seconds left for you to hit me. Actually, you got 5 hours and 15 seconds. Because you guys were a little cocky this week, so you'd be drinking beers by 7 or 8 o'clock. And I said, if you do, I'm gonna get you a limo. We're gonna get out and do a little something. Well, you got it done by 7 o'clock, so guess what? I'm a man of my word. I'll get you guys a car. We're gonna go out and we're gonna have a good time tonight, all right?
Sweet.
All
right.
Give yourselves a big group hug. Good job.
Yeah,
look loud with Mardi Gras House. Nice.
But there's one more team member to congratulate, Sean's mom.
Oh, mama.
How are you?
Good, mom. How are you?
Turn it up. I'm fine, Dr. Dinkle.
Well, I do believe we just set a new Monster House record. We finished at 7 o'clock, and that's 5 hours early. And a lot of it is thanks to you, because without your information, I wouldn't have known what I was doing.
Monster House rocks!
You guys kicked ass this week. You got down at 7 o'clock. You broke the Monster House record. And I couldn't be any prouder than I am right now to be able to say that I worked with you guys this week. I mean, really, it was an awesome job. So give yourselves a hand. You guys rock.
All right. Awesome. Yeah.
And for that, I got to give you something. So you get some prizes. Here it is, guys. Guys, from Makita, you get a cordless combo kit, a compound miter saw, and a top handle jigsaw. From Aesop, a mini arc welder, and a cutting and welding kit. And from Stanley, a professional builder's tool set right here, guys. It's all yours. You all get all of that.
Yeah!
Big hand. Thank you very much, guys. You rock.
But before the Waldens can reclaim their home, Jerry and her crew need to parade inside and work their Mardi Gras magic.
Totally frantic right now. There's so much cleaning to do in here, get up the drapes. I have somebody helping me in the other room hang lights down Bourbon Street. It's starting to look awesome. I talked to Mary at the mask store. I told her I was going with a jazzy feel. She sent me these masks and they're beautiful. They're gonna be so amazing in that club room. There's another hammer over there, Gabriel.
Vincent the Iguana gets a special sneak preview.
All right, you guys ready? Ready?
Oh,
All right. Good.
All right, guys, well, I think it's about that time.
All right, here we go.
Right.
The build team watches on a monitor in the backyard.
Welcome to the French Quarter.
Oh my God.
That is so cool.
Look at the floor.
Look at Bourbon Street.
God bless you.
Oh my gosh. All right.
So let's take a walk down Bourbon Street. You got a little breakfast nook back here.
Oh, nice.
You're on a little bistro, cool. French Quarter.
Oh, this table is fun.
All right, and you got this. This is a scene from the French Quarter right here.
Hey, there's my cousin.
It's Mardi Gras. Gotta have a little bit of confetti. That thing blows 200 miles an hour, so you're gonna have a few messes you have to clean up. That's all right, though. It's me. Oh, we got fun. Plantation shutters.
I got my plantation one.
Yeah.
Nice.
New casing, everything.
That's sweet.
Oh, wow. My God, look at my railing. I got...
You got the new master?
Hello.
Al built this for you. He fabricated this. It looks great.
Look at the drama faces.
All the master handmade.
Whoa.
And so this is the outside of a blues bar. All right, okay. So this is your blues bar.
Okay.
But behind here, you got a karaoke machine back here, guys.
Oh,
now, who knows the Monster House theme song?
I do.
You know it?
And a man started moving, something like that. Like the house, it's a monster house.
I got news for you. There's more. There's more.
I don't think my husband can take any more.
All right, guys, welcome to your new blues club.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Look at this.
You got new flooring in here?
Yes.
We built you this bar right here. You got some bar stools. And we got a new home for Vincent. That pulls out on the other side so you can get to him.
Oh, yeah. Sweet.
It's on wheels.
Oh, my goodness.
And of course, this is all, we got the hardwood, you got the mass, and we're handmade in Italy.
So, look at that. That's freaking awesome. Yeah, it's beautiful.
Well, it's not Mardi Gras without a big, crazy Mardi Gras masked float. So that's what this is, your new entertainment center right here. 52-inch HD TV audio visual system, 5.1 surround sound system from Just In Time Communications. Hooked you guys up.
Oh my God.
And just in case you want to have karaoke over here.
Oh look at that!
Yeah. It totally turns around.
Got access to all your components right here. Oh, everything you need. Let me introduce you to the builders. They worked their butts off this week. Come on in, guys. Come on in.
Woo!
Sean, Tomcat, great job, guys.
This is awesome, man.
Love it? Do you love it? Do you love it? She loves it. She loves it.
Hey, what's up, TC?
What's up, man?
Glad you're alive. Very cool. This rocks.
All right.
This rocks. This is awesome.
Amazing.
Okay.
Amazing.
All right.
Well, guys, you rock.
Until next time, when who knows, the monster might be coming to your town.
Love it.
It's a monster house. It's a monster house. And we all just love it. It's a monster house.
At Mardi Gras, we party all day through and all night long. So order up your favorite drink and sing your favorite song.